And a good Monday to each and every one of you. Hope everybody had a great weekend. Jewel here with the J7409 Weather Channel. Welcome to everyone. We got some stuff going on, folks. Let's hop right into it. This is the 32K NAM map from Tropical Tidbits. Thank you, Levi, my friend, for letting us use this. As you can see, bright and early during the daytime hours. Heavy, heavy snow. We got some blizzard warnings going on along with winter weather warnings and watches. So keep in mind what's going on. We're going to have some rain come through and some more rain's going to set up around Florida today. So let's turn this on right quick. And it's all because of a low pressure system now. It's going to produce rain over the northeast and parts of the Ohio Valley with moderate to heavy rain and rain over parts of the northeast. Therefore, there's a marginal risk of some excessive rainfall over parts of the northeast through Tuesday morning. Now, the associated heavy rain, that's going to create, of course, localized areas of flash flooding that could happen, affecting the areas that experience rapid runoff with heavy rain. Moreover, showers and thunderstorms are going to develop over parts of Florida through this evening. Now, on the northwest side of this storm, we got heavy snow. It's developing over parts of the upper great areas, producing additional amounts of near a foot around Lake Superior. Now, by this evening, Monday evening, looking like the snow will begin to taper off some. However, though, snow is still going to linger over parts of the Great Lakes through Tuesday evening. Furthermore, your temperatures today will be 10 to 20 degrees below average over parts of the upper middle Mississippi Valley, upper Great Lakes, Ohio Valley. Rain and snow then should linger over parts of the northeast through Wednesday morning. Meanwhile, we got a front over the northern Rockies to the Great Basin. That's going to move eastward to the upper Midwest and Central Plains by Wednesday. Now, weak onshore flow and upper level energy should create some coastal rain at the higher elevation, snow over the Pacific Northwest and northern California, with snow that's going to extend into parts of the Sierra Nevada Mountains. Now, that's going to begin to taper off Tuesday into Tuesday evening. On Tuesday, rain and snow will develop over parts of the northern Rockies and northern high plains. Now, as this system begins to move out of the Rockies, moisture will flow northward over the southern plains overnight tonight, and that's going to result early on Tuesday with showers coming up Tuesday. Showers and thunderstorms will start to develop over the central and southern plains. And in addition to that, well, overnight Tuesday, showers and more thunderstorms will develop over parts of the northern central plains and to parts of the middle Mississippi Valley. Taking a quick look at the watches and warnings map for today, right now going on up in these areas. You can see, look at all of this, where it's in the pink, winter storm warnings going on. And right here where it's a more redder color, you guys are under a blizzard warning. That's what's happening. This red is fire weather, okay? Fire weather. This wind warnings, or I should say advisories, over in Nevada where it's darker brown, and in portions of California, these are more heavier wind warnings. The wind's going to pick up as this system moves in from the west, and you can see portions of California up into Oregon, right in here. You guys are under a winter weather advisory because you are going to be having some snow to start coming in later today, probably going through some part of Tuesday morning. Everybody else, this blue right here, this is a frost warning for you guys in Illinois. It will run through tomorrow morning, and we do have the winter weather advisories in the blue surrounding it. Other than that, everything else that you see on the map are just fog warnings for this morning, which should burn up by later on this morning for the fog advisories. Quick look at the temperatures today. Remember I just told you it was going to be much cooler up around this area. These are daytime highs in Fahrenheit, looking like portions of Indiana, northern Indiana. You're going to have a high of 38 today, somewhere in that ballpark area there. Same thing goes for northern and northeastern Illinois, moving up in Wisconsin, 36. You can see you're going to be much, much cooler today than you have been. Now, by tomorrow, things should start to warm up just a little bit for you. You can see where the hot spots are. Parts of northern Texas, the Texas Panhandle, the Oklahoma Panhandle, Kansas, you guys are going to be in the 80s. A little cooler temperatures are going to blow in as that system moves through down around parts of North Carolina, South Carolina, maybe northern Georgia. Still going to be warm though, in the 70s, not bad at all. Cooler as that system moves in from the west, as you can see for you guys. And by Wednesday, everybody's going to start to warm up again, except where this next system that blows in is coming through. You're going to have daytime highs in the lower 50s to maybe upper 40s for the most part. Over here, you can see in New York, you're going to have some 50s over in this area here. Over in Maine, you're looking good. You're going to be in the 50s for Wednesday. I want to take just a moment to ask you, have you prayed today? Please pray today. Have you read your Bible today? If it's not but two or three verses, please take the time to do so. We're living in a world that's only going to get worse and worse in every way, my friends. Put on the full armor of God and be ready for whatever comes your way with Jesus Christ, your Savior. Severe weather. No severe weather today. Yes, rain's going to happen, but no severe weather with downdraft winds, large hail, tornadoes. Nothing today. I don't think anything will happen tomorrow. This is Wednesday we're looking at here. Yes, it might look a little threatening, but I don't think right now tornadoes will pop up. They might, but I don't think so as of now. I'll keep you posted on it. But where you see all this significant stuff, that's hail, my friends. Some of this hail from portions of Kansas, Nebraska, northern Missouri, Iowa, some of this hail associated with these storms could be 2 inches or bigger by Wednesday. Everything's setting up for this to be a hail event. So, you know, make sure you got your cars covered, put up if at all possible. So, I'm just trying to warn you ahead of time. Looking like this will be a Wednesday and a Wednesday night event. It could happen off and on all day Wednesday, all through Wednesday night. So be prepared and don't get cut short with not having things protected, because it does look like it could produce some large hail and a lot of it. Okay, my friends, that's what it's looking like right now. What's going to happen today through Wednesday? Have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day, my friends. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to share this with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of just what might be coming their way. I love you all. May each of you have much peace, love, and kindness in your life today. Thank you again for watching.